Hey guys, so obviously the video I did worked. So now I want to get a little more personal and kind of give you some background. I might have before, but a quick refresher maybe. So when I was born, my father decided that life just wasn't any fun anymore after I was born. So he cheated on my mother and he left. Big surprise. So I actually was blessed with a really, really great first stepdad. Gave us the world on a string. He was a wonderful stepfather, but a horrible husband. Lied about paying the bills, so on and so on. We almost lost the house. So that led to my mother's divorce, and then she met the one who changed me. So abusive, really funny. That's where I started, really getting more prominent to cutting and all the other dangerous behavior I was doing, running the streets. He was a horrible person. So he finally killed himself when I was getting help. And he saw me one last time, apologized for everything he did, asked my forgiveness. I'm the kind of person who, if somebody asks for my forgiveness, I'm not gonna sit there and say, "No, I'm not gonna forgive you." So I forgave him, and I welcomed him back into the picture, and he said, "I'm not coming back." And I said, "What do you mean?" And he looked at me really serene, and he said, "You'll see." I pretty much knew right then that he was gonna die. Apparently, he took his life a day later in the Georgia mountains. So, nice. Then I met what would become my dad in the long run. I actually got married on my birthday. Not the best birthday present, but had a lot of problems. And again, I was living on and off the streets and acting all crazy. And needless to say, they divorced, so, well, separated the day before 9/11 and divorced, I want to say near Christmas. It was a pretty quick divorce, actually. I did not have any contact with him for many, many years. And then my best friend got married, and we always used to tease each other that we would be best men in our each other's weddings. And around this time I had seen my ex-stepdad online, because if you guys remember anything about Yahoo Mail, the older version would let you see people who are still online. I saw him and I asked my mother's blessing to get in touch with him, and she did. I mean, we'd all moved on with our lives, and this is when I was still obviously dating my husband. But we reconnected, and I went up there for my best friend's wedding, and we had no place to stay, so he invited us to stay with him and his then girlfriend, and really great. My stepdad and I really reconnected, and I asked if he would mind that I called him dad, because I don't, even before my father died, I didn't have a relationship with him. Which we'll go on to that in another study. So I gave him a big hug because I was really happy to have a dad again. And went to my best friend's wedding, did the whole being best man. But I thought it'd be really funny if I wore a tux, and his wife would not let me wear a tux. So I had to get two dresses for that wedding. But I still stood on my best friend's side as best person. So anyway, flash forward to where we are now. It was really awesome. I got married about a year and a half later, and I called my best friend first. I'm like, "Oh my God, he's gonna propose to me." And I said, "Well, do you still want to be my best man?" He said, "Of course." Now, keep in mind, this was a pact we made as teenagers. We are in our 30s and 40s now, so it's a really long time to keep a promise and fulfill it. Because I did not have a relationship with my biological father, I asked my stepdad to walk me down the aisle to ask my dad, which it was a wonderful feeling. He has a wonderful wife that, she's not my stepmom, she's my mom. You don't have to be family to have somebody be your family. My mom has been there through so much for me, and we talk every day, if not on the phone or a video call, we text, and we've been there to support each other. And it's really great to have somebody I communicate with daily who doesn't bully me. She's given me a lot of good advice, and for all intents and purposes, she's my mother. She hasn't given up on me. She's never, you know, thinking I was too out there or too out of control. She just loves me, and I love her. I was kind of scared when I first met my stepmom, because I had so many bad experiences with stepparents. My first stepmom was just crazy. That's all I can say. She was crazy. And my stepmom embraced me from the very second that I met her. I was like, wow, this is awesome. I finally have someone I can really talk to. She's gotten mad at me just like any mom would do. I was really acting out and really pissed her off. My stepmom's very scary when she gets mad. Don't get mad often. But I really upset her, and I don't want to do it again. So we talk. If there's something wrong, we just talk about it. And it's really nice to have my dad to talk to. Like I said, I consider him my dad, even though my parents are not married anymore, and they haven't been for a while. I was so proud of him to walk me down the aisle and have our father-daughter dance. It was a beautiful experience, and that's kind of where we're at today. So, I don't like to make these videos too long, because nobody has a huge attention span, unless it's something funny. And sometimes I'm not very funny. These are kind of more serious videos. If you guys would like to see anything else, let me know. I'm open to pretty much all topics. So, I'm gonna let you guys go for now, and any topics are welcome. Just keep it clean. I do stay true to my Christian faith and my Christian beliefs. So, if y'all are crass, I will boot you off my channel and report you. So, that being said, y'all have a great day.